Good morning students. Today we are going to discuss ANOVA one-way problem. ANOVA one-way problem. So when we can use the ANOVA one-way? When we can use the ANOVA one-way means if you come across with more than two samples. If you come across with more than two samples, we have to use the ANOVA. Okay? ANOVA one-way. When you can use one-way means if the problem depends upon the one factor, then use the ANOVA one way. So what are the assumptions for the ANOVA one way? The samples should be independently drawn from the populations. So remember the point, independently drawn from the population. The second point is populations should have the same variance. So if you are choosing the three samples from three populations, so these three populations should have the same variance. Next one is these three populations have normally distributed. Those three populations should be normally distributed. So that he is saying. Next one. So first one is the independently. Second one is the it is same variance. Third one is the normally distributed. Normally distributed. So next one. The problem what he has given is the three samples. So he has given the three samples, that means more than two. We have to use the ANOVA. Each of the size so and so he has given. So the first sample he has given, how many item observations are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, each of size 5. Okay, the second sample is this one, the third sample is this one. What we have to finally conclude is test the hypothesis that population has same means or not. This sample is from one population, this sample is from second population, and this sample is from third population. We have to check it whether the populations has the same mean or not. We have to check it, okay, in ANOVA. So first one, so here the within the sample means, this means you have to remember the wording. Within the sample means variance within the sample means, so variance means here the lowest value is 9, let us consider, highest value is 16, that means here the difference is 7. So variation of the observations within the sample. So between the sample means these two. Variation between these two samples. Within the sample means the in the same sample. Between the sample means between x1 and x2 or x1, x3 or x2, x3. Okay, that the wording you have to remember. Next, we have to find out x1 square. In the examination, he is not going to provide this one. We have to calculate the x1 square. 10 square 100, 12 square 144, like that. Similarly, x2 square, 9 square is 81, 7 square is 49. 11 square is 121. Similarly, x3 square, if you do that one, you are going to get 196, 16 square is 256. So if you calculate this one, you are going to get the table is like this. Okay, summation of the x1, if you add all these values, you are going to get 60. Summation of the x1 square, it is 750. Similarly, x2 square, similarly x3 and x3 square values already I have noted. That means this is sigma x1, this is sigma x1 square, sigma x2, similarly sigma x2 square, sigma x3, similarly sigma x3 square. Okay, next, the populations are normal populations, already he has given. Next one, equal variance, with equal variances, already he has given that problem itself. So our assumptions are followed: normal population and equal variances. Now we are doing H naught. What we have to conclude, what we have to take, the three populations have the equal means. So mu1 is equal to mu2 is equal to mu3. So H1 should be mu1 comma mu2 comma mu3 are not all equal. Suppose if mu 2 is not equal to mu 3, if mu 1 is equal to mu 2 and mu 2 is not equal to mu 3 happened, then also we will reject the hypothesis. So mu 1 should be equal to mu 2 should be equal to mu 3 only, then only we can accept the null hypothesis. So level of significance, level of significance he never mentioned, he has mentioned at 5% level, therefore level of significance is 5%. So now again coming to the problem, how many observations are there in each sample? So n1 is equal to 5, in the second sample 5, therefore I have written it as n2 is equal to 5, in the third sample 5 observations are there, therefore I have written it as n3 is equal to 5. Now point number 1 step, we have to find out capital T. Capital T stands for summation sigma x1, sigma x2 plus sigma x3. Sigma x1 is 60, sigma x2 is 50, sigma x3 is 70. So you add the values, how much you are going to get? 180. Capital T is 180. Similarly, you have to find out capital N. Capital N stands for small n1, n2 plus n3. If you do that one, you are going to get as 15. Okay. Now correction factor formula is, what it says is capital T whole square by N. Capital T whole square by N. Capital T is how much? 180. That means 180 whole square. N capital N stands for 15. Capital N stands for 15. Therefore, 180 whole square by 15, 2160 is the correction factor. Okay, 2160 is the correction factor. First step, what we did is the finding a correction factor. Next, SSB. Next, we are going to find out the SSB. What is meant by SSB means sum of the squares between the columns. Okay, SSB, that means what we have to do is the sigma x1 whole square. Sigma x1 is this much, not sigma 1 square whole square, sigma x1 whole square. Sigma x1 is how much? 60. 60 whole square by n1 is 5. Similarly, sigma 2 whole square, sigma 2 is 50, 50 whole square. Sigma 3 is how much? 70, 70 whole square. So minus correction factor, the formula is SSB is equal to, this is the formula. So just substitute all the values, how much you are going to get? It is 40. Sigma x1 is how much? Sigma x1 is 60. In place of sigma x2, write 50. In place of sigma x3, write 70. N1 anyway, n1 is 5, n2 is 5, n3 is 5. Just substitute in this one. And the correction factor is 2160. Just substitute here. Finally, you are going to get 440. TSS stands for total sum of squares. So that formula is minus correction factor. Sigma x1 square, not sigma x1 whole square, sigma x1 square. So sigma x1 square is this one. That means 750. Sigma x2 square, 516. Sigma x3 square, 994. Add these values and subtract correction factor. So what you are going to get it as 100. Sigma x1 square how much? 750. Sigma x2 square 516. Sigma x3 square 994 minus 2160. Do that one, you are going to get 100. Next, TSS is nothing but SSB plus SSW. TS, total sum of squares, is nothing but SSB plus SSW. So in the next slide I will explain what is exactly SSB, SSW. So from this one you conclude, you know the SSB value and TSS value. So SSW is equal to how much you are going to get? TSS minus SSB. That means TSS is how much? 100. SSB is 40. So what you left with is 60. SSW is nothing but 60. Remember this one. Okay. Next. Now you come across with what is meant by SSB. SSB stands for sum of squares between the samples. SSB stands for sum of squares between the samples. Whereas SSW stands for sum of squares within the samples. Sum of squares between the samples, sum of squares within the samples. TSS stands for total sum of squares. Next one, degree of freedom is K k minus 1. What is k here means number of samples. Number of samples, how many samples we have given in the problem? 3 samples has given. Therefore, k stands for 3. This remember, k stands for 3. Okay, similarly, capital N stands for how much means? Capital N means the total observations in all the samples. Total observations. Each sample has 5. So, 3 samples, how much? 15. Therefore, capital N is equal to 15. Okay? Okay, next, capital N minus 1 anyway. Here, mean MSB stands for mean squares between the samples. MSB stands for mean squares between the samples. Whereas, MSW stands for mean squares within the samples. Already we have discussed within and between the samples. So, MSB, how will you find out? SSB by K minus 1. SSW by this value. Finally, F value, how will you find out? MSB by MSW. Okay. Now, we will go through our problem. Okay. How much you are going to get SSB? SSB is 40. You got 40. Within the samples. So, degree of freedom. Total degree of freedom here. How many samples? 3 samples are there. Therefore, 3 minus 1. Therefore, 2 degree of freedom. MSB is equal to how much? 40 by 2. That means 20. Next, within the samples, SSW. Already you got that value is 60. So, degree of freedom is capital N minus K. Capital N minus K. Capital N is total observations 15. Minus number of samples is how much? Number of samples is 3. 15 minus 3 means 12. So, MSW means 60 by 12. 5. Next. Here total is 100. Here it is 14. Not 12 plus 2. Don't think like that. Capital N minus 1. Total observations is 15. 15 minus 1 is equal to 14. Test statistic F means MSB by MSW. That means 20 by 5. Therefore, F is equal to 20 by 5. That is equal to 4. This is our calculated F. This is our calculated F. Now, what you have to find out? You have to find out tabulated F. Tabulated F, how will you find out? Numerator degree of freedom versus denominator degree of freedom. In numerator, we have the 20. For 20, degree of freedom is 2. In the denominator, 5. 5 concerned degree of freedom is 12. Therefore, for 2, 12 degree of freedom, for 5% level of significance, the value is 3.89. Numerator degree of freedom 2 and denominator degree of freedom is 12. So, the value is 3.9, tabulated F. Therefore, calculated F is 4, tabulated F is 3.89. Calculated F is greater than tabulated F. Therefore, H0 is rejected. That means means are not equal. So, means are not equal. This is about the ANOVA one way. So, here, based upon the one factor, we are doing the problem. That's why ANOVA one way. Okay, thank you.